Hurry up, you guys. If the Coast Guard catches us, we're in big trouble.
Hey, take it easy, old man. There was top secret Navy material on board the Cleveland. We're going down to retrieve it. We're gonna sell it, and we're gonna be rich.
You've only got 3 minutes of air left.
Going till dawn, that sort of thing, if that's all right with you.
Thank you. Something smells fishy here.
Don't worry, we're just gonna go say hi to the guys, okay? Hi, Susie.
Vanessa, so you finally came back. You're more beautiful than ever.
You're quite a little missy yourself, Susie.
Cookie, go home now.
You've really gotten quite good.
I have two great teachers, Cookie and Daisy. Come and let me introduce you to Poppy.
It's good to have you back here with us, Billy.
It was terrible. When we heard about the accident, we just couldn't believe it.
It's a terrible thing, all right. In a split second, I lost everything. I lost my wife, my will to live, most of all, Susie's smile. She'll never be able to walk again. Fortunately, she's a strong kid, and here at the aquarium, she's found some reason to live. Every time she feels like a normal kid when she's out there in the water.
Cookie and Daisy, only listen to her. And Poppy, she's got a crush on her.
So how are things here, Dag?
Well, the overheads are high. Shows a few. But the season's good, and Bob wins the regatta. We should come out on top.
I should have a fighting chance this year. I've been training all winter.
Hi, Dag.
Hi, Francis. What can I do for you?
I'm sorry, this isn't a social call. I have an order to evict from Samuel Lewis. We've got to be out of here in 30 days. I'm really sorry.
Yeah, well, you've always been a good friend, Sheriff. Besides, 30 days is a long time. A lot of things can happen.
Sure, all we have to do is give him an advance rent for the next 15 years.
That fat money-grubbing bastard. I'd like to rip his balls off.
Well, that ain't... Don't listen to him. He's young. He's hot-headed. That's all.
Hey, Billy.
How you doing, Sheriff?
Good. How's your research going?
Pretty good. This winter, I'm sailing on the Cuddy Shark.
The Cuddy Shark.
That's right. That floating madhouse for fish freaks. Scientific research. 18 months at sea.
Get over here. Hey! Ronnie!
No.
Hey, Ronnie, stop!
At you again!
Get back here!
Ronnie. Quick enough.
Hey, why don't you go bust somebody else's balls?
Go take a swim.
What swim? I'm gonna go fool around.
Billy, I got you down here because I need your opinion on this. This looks like the work of a speedboat propeller to me.
Well, I can't say anything until I take a look at it, Francis.
Officer, have them all move back.
Hey, move back, everybody. Move back. Coming through. Make
Christ.
Move back.
Well, what do you think?
In my opinion, it wasn't a speedboat propeller.
Then what was it?
Could have been a shark.
A shark and it did that?
At least that's what I think. I say a shark, but it could have been a killer whale.
Billy, I need a precise answer here.
Francis, these remains have been in the water for more than 24 hours. There's no saying how many fish have been feeding on it. An autopsy is the only way you're going to get a precise answer.
do you see, Rick?
Not even the propeller of a transatlantic ocean liner could do this. It was a shark, all right. And a big one.
Are you all out of your minds?
Sheriff, for heaven's sakes, let's not go off on a wild goose chase here. It happens. We'll die now and then under unfortunate circumstances.
You know, folks around here are waiting for the season to open. If word gets out that a shark tore a driver to bits, hey, you can kiss the tourist season.
I'm sorry. If there is a shark around here, gentlemen, we don't have any choice. We have to close the beach, and we have to postpone the regatta.
It was an accident, just an accident. No sharks involved, no fins.
Hey, was the propeller of a fishing boat?
What about the coroner's report?
Francis, now, the coroner called me 2 minutes ago. He said he could be wrong.
Why, hell, you know how many people drowned in accidents? Are you gonna blame them all on sharks, too?
Yeah, maybe. There's only one shark that can do a job like this.
And which one is that?
The tiger shark. From the judge of things, it's gotta have a mouth like this.
Did you see that? A super baby. She tits on her like watermelon. You like them all as long as they're breathing.
Hey, that's enough, isn't it?
Yoo-hoo, Ronnie!
Look who's here.
Yeah. What a pity she hangs out with that nerd fish doctor, Billy.
I don't know, maybe nothing will happen, but I'm sure we'll score, man. Vanessa is hot to trot.
Hi, Bob.
Oh, hi, Gloria. Looks like your little sister has a crush on the Viking son.
How's Susie? I want to see her after the show tonight.
I don't think that's such a good idea. Seems to be a little bad feeling between your dad and mine. I wouldn't want to do anything.
Do you always do what your daddy tells you to?
No.
Well then, I'll see you at the aquarium at 8. Hey, wait for me, I'm coming too.
Nat, hold it.
What do you want?
I'm the person in charge of pussy. I have to, you know, check your credentials.
Dick brain.
Am I disturbing your dad?
No, it's all right. Come on in.
What did Billy and Francis want last night?
Those crazy bastards. They got it in their heads there's a shark around here. They want Godfrey to close the beaches and me to call off the regatta. And they want to make the news public. The result would be massive cancellations.
If you ask me, Dag Soerensen's behind us. He wants to get back at you because you sent him that eviction notice.
No. No, he's got too much to lose.
Do you know that Gloria has got a crush on Bob? He hangs around like a bad smell.
Why, that dirty little bastard up there is fucking balls off!
I don't think that'll be necessary. I've got a better idea.
First I want to swim.
Why now?
Later.
It's entertaining.
What a pain in the ass. You go by yourself and I will wait for you here.
You don't know what you're missing. Come on, don't be so lazy.
had your dinner? Where's my little Daisy? Don't pay any attention. Poppy's jealous.
Good girl.
Where's Cookie?
Enough for tonight, honey. It's time for supper.
Just a little while longer, please, Daddy. Gloria's having such fun.
It's late for Gloria, too. She's gonna get in trouble with her dad. Isn't that right, Gloria?
Sure is, and he won't let me have any dessert.
All right. But promise me you'll come back tomorrow.
Take Gloria home. Don't be too long.
Good night, Cookie. Good night, Daisy.
Dad hasn't been the same since Mom died, and Susie lost the use of her legs. When he was young, he was a great sailor. He used to hunt whales in the North Sea. And ever since that damn accident, he hasn't been the same. First your dad thrown us out of the aquarium, and then that shark. Things couldn't get any worse.
I'm sorry.
I gotta do something. I can't let Susie be shacked up in that apartment.
I feel so ridiculous. When you see and feel certain things, you suddenly realize how futile the things you strive for are.
Then why'd you come tonight?
I wanted to see Susie. And you.
We got here in time.
It's in the moment to dick around.
Still got work.
Giving them a special filling. Strychnine nitrate with rat poison.
The Viking's in for a nasty surprise in the morning, boys.
Where are you, little dolphins? Come here. Gonna fix your wagons.
Damn fish are gonna wake everybody up.
Quick, just throw them that stuff and let's get out of here.
Come on, dolphins. Here, boy. Come and get it.
Take it easy, Daisy. What's gotten into you?
What's this? Get Billy immediately. Someone's trying to force the dolphins.
Sorry to wake you, Sheriff.
Let's talk in here. You have a good reason for waking me up this early in the morning.
He says his girlfriend's been eaten by a shark.
Eaten by a shark? He must be stewed to the gills. I'll give him the test, and then I'll throw him in the who's got for drunkenness. No, wait. I want to interrogate him.
We got him just in time. Everything's gonna be fine now.
Thanks, Joe. We had another shark attack last night.
Where?
At Old Beach. A woman, a certain Katie Adams. I sent a couple of my men down to check it out.
Well, if the territorial theory is correct, and what I assume is true, there's gonna be a lot of trouble down there, Francis.
Billy, what do we know about sharks?
Well, we know that they're a sort of locomotive with a mouth full of butcher's knives. And all they really know how to do is swim, eat, and make baby sharks. And that's all.
So if we were to have the regatta, it would be like saying, help yourself, chow's on.
And there are only two ways to get rid of them. Kill them, or starve them.
Very clever, these dolphins, Dag.
What do you want?
I came to show the property to these friends of mine, and I have the plans for the hotel that's going to be built right here. The sunset's right in front of us. I mean, it is gorgeous, right there. It's a beautiful sight to see. Look. You leave right away, I'll give you a nice hunk of cash. It'll keep you going for a couple of years, all right?
You're some kind of a son of a bitch, Sam.
What did you say?
I said you're a son of a bitch!
Look, if you need more information on the sports program or the entertainment programs, my secretary is at your disposal. Take the folks back to the hotel and I'll be right there, okay?
That is it! You're doing the wrong thing, refusing my offer. You are.
Not only do I refuse the offer, but I'll beat the shit out of anyone who tries to poison my dolphins.
Don't even know what you're talking about. And
don't be so wicked, Mr. Lewis. Gloria cares about Pookie and Daisy, too.
By the way, tell your Bob to stay away from my daughter, or you can buy another wheelchair.
He's nothing but a fucked up windbag.
Sam!
You going to see the mayor too?
Just the man I wanted to see. Come on with me. Oh, Godfrey, we're here, Patricia.
You are obsessed!
Obsessed my ass!
Who would let you speak to me like this? Listen, Godfrey. This morning, that loser of a Viking threw me in his pool. You can't trust the man. He's a madman. His contract is clear. He hasn't paid his rent for 3 months, and I...
You may not have to worry about that. If things keep going the way they are, Hampton Bay is going to be deserted.
You've got it in your head that there's a killer shark around here. What do you want us to do? Godfrey, are you willing to take responsibility for condemning this town to a winter of starvation?
Sam, Mayor Jefferson, this shark is a perfect machine, a man-eating machine, and it's already taken the lives of two people.
Put shark nets around a boundary to regatta. Inform the Coast Guard to patrol the coast with helicopters and boats. Call in extra officers from nearby counties. I refuse to put off the regatta or the ceremony, and I'll pay for everything.
That sounds like an excellent idea.
We'll have it your way. But remember, you're the ones who wanted to open up a diner for sharks.
Just as well, then. She's early. I'll just tell her to go on without me.
That sounds good to me.
Listen, Glenda.
Hi, Vanessa. Is Billy in?
Yeah, come on in.
Hey, Francis, what's up?
Bill, we need you right now. The shark cages have arrived.
Billy's busy. We got invited to the club tonight.
No, it's okay, Vanessa. Go on, Glenda. I'll catch up with you later on.
Once and for all, Billy, it is the fish or me. What do I have to do to get you to pay attention to me? Grow gills?
Hey, forget about it. I'll take care of this.
No, really. Vanessa, it won't take very long. Come on, this is really important.
Hold on, Glenda. I'll be right there. Billy, I want you to find the tallest skyscraper you can and throw yourself off, and then go fuck yourself.
Nice temper.
Dad, why do sharks eat people?
Because they're hungry. They're always hungry, I think.
Does blood come out if a shark eats you?
Yes, and you're going to have nightmares if you keep talking about sharks.
If a shark tried to eat me, I'd punch him in the nose.
Don't worry. No shark's going to eat you.
Why not? If I go swimming, I bet one will try. But Daisy and Cookie will tear him to pieces.
That's enough. Here we are. Once upon a time, there was a little boy called Tom Thumb. He lived in a small house with his parents and his three little brothers and sisters. They were very hungry because they were very poor. And one night...
I should have listened because Father knows best.
Everybody's here. They're gonna die when they see you dressed like this.
Look who's talking.
Bad attitude. Bad attitude.
Sexy mama. Woo! Yes!
I wanna dance.
Yeah.
You know, Tommy, you give off a certain animal magnetism.
Hey, I'm a sex machine. I even got a spare set of balls.
So, does that mean you got enough to go around?
Excuse me, I forgot my life saver.
I hope you drown.
Feeling a little depressed?
To tell you the truth, I'm pissed. I'm bored to death. Every day is the same old story.
Aren't you going with Billy?
Him. All he cares about are groupers and flatheads.
What are you doing, belly dancing?
I'm an artist. Michelangelo will work with stone.
Van Gogh work with canvas.
And, you know,
What do you use for a doctora? A walnut shell with a piece of elastic?
I'm desperately lonely. Free? Confused? Generous? Above all. Full of love. It's written in my eyes. Why don't we go someplace else?
Okay.
name, Vanessa.
Vanessa? She went off with Prince Charming to the beach of passion.
Ronnie behaves that way because he wants to emulate my father.
My father acts the way he does because your father gave him that eviction notice.
We have to keep seeing each other behind in secret.
I love this place. Just think, the first time I came here, I hated it.
Well, let's run away together.
How?
Easy, we just send everybody to help me run away.
No, it's not.
I don't want you to go away. I want you to go away.
Come on, wait a minute. My shoes. Take them off. Vanessa. Come on in, it's warm.
Ocean.
Ronnie gets them all.
Let's scare the shit out of them.
Good idea.
Hampton Bay police! Don't you dirty little devils know you're polluting the ocean doing that?
I'm Ronnie Lewis. Samuel Lewis's son.
Is it me or are you in this shit up to your neck?
Wait a minute. Glenda? Tommy? Is that you?
It's us, all right. And you two jerks fell for this whole thing like a ton of bricks.
You lousy coward.
Everyone, myself, and let you know that we have the interest of the city at heart. And now Sheriff Berger here will illustrate all of the precautions that we have taken to protect the regatta zone. Sheriff.
As you can see, we've completely protected this area of the coastline with a special shark net that goes from here to here. Special observation posts have been set up at strategic locations, and armed men are on board boats anchored just on the other side of the net, placed here, here, and here. So the entire area where the regatta is going to be is completely protected, 100%.
Ladies and gentlemen, absolutely nothing will happen. You have my word on that.
sir. Excuse me. Is this the beach where we can see the shark from?
What shark?
The one that killed all those folks. They said it on TV. They said there's a shark killing people right here.
There was a shark, but now it's gone, and we hope that it doesn't come back.
You mean to say we came all this way and now it's gone? They didn't say that on TV.
There's nothing I can do about that. Will you please just move on?
Baloney.
But I thought we were gonna go see the shark.
Ronnie, shut up.
Look down there. Isn't that a shark?
It's him, all right, the son of a bitch. I'll fix him. Go lower. I have to get him first. Otherwise, the bass will dive down, and that'll be that.
I got him in the head. We can go back to base. I'll tell the boats to go retrieve him.
Okay, Roger. We'll proceed with the retrieval operation.
Good work, guys. Over.
Quick, quick, let's follow the cop. I think we're gonna see the shark. Come on, gather the things up. Come on. Let's go.
What a big mouth. It's bigger than a big bad wolf, isn't it, Daddy?
Well, it's a tiger shark, all right.
Daddy, does that mean that its daddy was a shark and its mommy was a tiger?
Call the press agencies immediately, NCBS, the news networks, the radio stations, and go and find Dawson and get him over here. I want pictures of everybody around that shark. Go. Francis.
Great job. Well done.
Thank you. I'm not saying that it isn't him. It probably is. They're very ferocious and very rare in these waters, but the fact of the matter is, Dag, this jaw span just doesn't convince me.
No, wait, what are you saying here?
You aren't talking nonsense, boy. You've been seeing too many movies.
You want to be sure, Mayor? You want to be sure, Mr. Lewis? All you have to do then is open him up and see what's in his stomach.
Don't talk rubbish, boy. This is not the place nor the time.
Officer Ramon, the Cuban.
What happened?
We found it adrift. It was half full of water. There was nobody aboard.
Now, you're not going to try and tell me that that was done by a shark, too.
If I were you, I'd cancel this regatta.
Everybody knows Ramon was into dynamite fishing. It was an explosion. He blew the back of his own boat off.
And even if it was a shark attack, well, the Coast Guard's got it by now.
Have that shark carcass towed out to sea, will you? It's going to stink up the whole goddamn town.
I've never missed this celebration in my whole life.
Hey. Oh, I bet you're a future champion of the Hampton Bay Regatta, huh?
Great day, Mr. Lewis. I hope Ronnie wins.
Thank you, man.
Mr. Lewis.
Oh, no, please, no.
We hope Ronnie Lewis is going to do himself proud again this year. Even though our champion is not going to have an easy time, he's going to have to deal with very well-trained opponents, especially young Bob Soerensen.
You let Bob win and you're on nothing.
I'll clean him when we round the first buoy.
Don't get caught in with the first run. Get the wind behind you, wait for the right moment.
I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah, that way you won't make an ass of yourself.
As you know, this regatta marks the beginning of the summer season in Hampton Bay and is sponsored by the Lewis Hotel chain, owned by Mr. Samuel Lewis.
The divers have checked the nets. The buoys are in place. The men are too. God, I just don't feel right about this, though.
I'm afraid, Francis.
That motherfucker is acting so strange. It's almost as if someone has trained him to attack and kill.
Let's keep our fingers crossed.
Five minutes to start time.
Wish me luck, huh?
Hey, you got your motor running. You're just saving for the victory celebration. I just can't figure you out.
I want you to watch out for Ronnie. He plays dirty.
Poppy and I will be rooting for you.
Don't worry. I'll beat the pants off that loudmouth. And with the prize money, we'll pay off Mr. Lewis.
Hi, Vanessa.
Hi, Susan. Mwah.
What is it, Billy?
He was on the pier with Francis.
Daddy, can I go watch the races with Vanessa?
Sure, but keep out of the way of the confusion, all right?
Let's go find Billy. Do is just dance, dance, dance. While there is rhythm, there will be no romance. Cause all you wanna do is just dance. Be careful.
Don't worry, I'll win for us too.
I'll rip his balls off and use them for earrings. Horrors him!
You worry about winning. We can take care of him later.
I'll shove his head underwater and drown him.
All contestants to the starting line. Two minutes to go.
Bob's too far back.
I told him to keep back. That way we won't have to turn tight.
30 seconds to go.
There isn't a shark in the world that can get through these nets.
I can believe it. They cost $30,000.
Aquarium goodbye, Mr. Dag Soerensen.
Silveria. Give me the binoculars.
Oh my God!
What's wrong?
Get them out of the water quick!
Okay. She's just fine. She's at home with Billy.
Sharks are really bad.
There are far worse animals.
Daddy?
What is it, honey?
Tell Poppy and the dolphins not to worry about me.
I sure will.
Not allowed.
Hey, I'm sorry. Yeah. Well, I couldn't.
You know what you got to do now, don't you, Sam?
What?
You're going to have to offer a reward of $100,000 to whoever brings in the head of that shark.
I don't have the authority. I mean, not without...
Without what? Without what, you fat fuck? Vanessa's dead because of you.
Everyone knows you're the one who opposed the regatta from being postponed.
Samuel Lewis, the big boss of Shark City. Is that what you want the newspapers and TV to call you?
Hey, I always acted in the interests of the town.
In the best interest of yourself, you mean.
Offer the reward. Do it for Vanessa and all the kids who lost their lives today.
This shark isn't going to be easy. He's a treacherous mother. It's not like fishing for sardines. We're dealing with a man-eater here. If he gets his teeth into you and clamps down with his jaws, you've had it.
Oh, come on. All you gotta do is put a bullet in its head and it's fucked, right?
The tiger shark we're looking for is a homicidal maniac. When it attacks here, here, in the middle of your belly and your guts are out, the trouble is, you're still alive when he starts eating you. Now that you know, you should have more respect for him. Billy, you're the expert. Take over.
The weak points of the tiger shark are here at the base of the head and underneath the dorsal fin. You must be precise. Only aim at these areas. And don't kid yourselves, because if this thing gets any idea whatsoever that you're in its presence, he's not going to leave you alone. So you have two choices. One, you can get the hell out of there. Or two, you can try to kill him. Because if you don't, he's going to kill you. Are there any questions?
If it was your decision to go ahead with the regatta, then our friends in New York are not going to be very happy.
All right. So a mistake was made, but I took all the necessary precautions.
Now the press is sticking their nose in our town business. We don't allow for mistakes, Sam. You know that.
What do you want me to do? Jump in and kill a damn thing myself? I offered a reward for it. What else could I do?
Just one thing. We've invested a lot of money in real estate in this town. So you better make sure that shark is eliminated immediately. Is that clear? And not in a week's time. Now.
In the past, I've solved more difficult problems than this for you. I'll solve this one, too.
You better. For your own good.
On your back, huh?
We'll get rid of that damn shark soon. The prices around here are gonna crash, and we are in deep trouble.
I've got a personal grudge with that. God damn. I'll bring his head myself.
Are you sure your old man isn't gonna be mad?
Well, right now he's got other things to worry about. Besides, when he sees us haul that shark in the port, he'd be too proud to be mad.
The kids of Hampton Bay avenged their friends and killed a shark. I can already see the headlines.
Now, what if we come back empty-handed?
You gotta be kidding me. I bet my ass will be hauling that bastard when we come back.
My father used to use this for hunting.
You see that? 12 gauge. Cool. Okay, guys, let's go. Wading in the Arctic Ocean.
All the half-asses wanted to become whalers so they could use the harpoon. Once off Greenland, I caught a whale about 20 meters long. I had to plant 3 harpoons in him so I could bring him in. These days, these whippersnappers, they bring along radar, sonar, even a microwave oven so they can heat up their sandwiches. But a lot of mighty fine stuff aboard here, Mr. Marson. Although I don't know what use that son of a bitch of a shark's gonna have for it, he may eat it. Once I had one try to eat the motor off my boat.
The shark we're looking for, Dag, is no ordinary shark. It's strange. Its behavior is anomalous.
Okay, let's get ready to lower this in the water.
Here's hoping he likes it. My mother's roast.
Okay, Tommy, start slowing down.
To the surface and then harpoon him as if he were a whale. Stupid, he'd think he'd get a shark on a fish hook like as if it were a cod.
Well, for want of anything better, maybe we can catch a few squid for tonight's dinner. Let's lower the bait. Maybe that'll bring him out.
It's the only thing for us.
Some fool hunting a shark with jet charges.
No, this one occurred on the surface. It was a big one, too. Bob!
Start her up, put her on a course north, northeast, full steam ahead.
Aye, sir.
Sheriff, we received a message from the Coast Guard. Lewis's boat exploded at sea.
No survivors.
Oh, shit. Inform the Coast Guard that all boats are to return to port at once. And I'll go tell Lewis the bad news.
Okay.
To go below and take a look. Something's blocked the rudder.
I'll go.
No, I'll go. I know more about mechanics.
Billy, you may be a whiz kid in the lab, but I see you're just ballast. Larry, stay here and make sure the boat doesn't get underway.
Okay. It's my job. I'm the helmsman.
I'm going down.
Don't worry, Dag. This thing will tell us if he's in danger. Tied around the propeller.
There's just too many half-assed fishermen around here.
Bob, when you were down there, did you notice anything unusual?
No. Well, yeah, there's a wreck down there.
Right over there.
It must be the Cleveland. We're over the banks off of Cape Barrels.
Attention.
Wasn't that the ship
Attention.
Carrying?
This is the Coast Guard. Return to the port immediately. Repeat. Return to the port immediately.
Something big must have happened in town.
Listen, Dag, the Cleveland was the ship carrying the...
We'll talk about it later. Bob, we're going back in.
Happens, you can get in touch with me by radio.
Okay, Sheriff.
your fucking brains out!
You to solve the problem, Sam, not create a disaster.
Oh, what else could I have done? That shark can't be taken. It killed my only son. It's destroyed my yacht, my helicopter. What else can I do?
Nothing. We've decided to take care of our business here in Hampton Bay by ourselves.
Are you saying...
Hey, Sam. Whatever you're thinking. This isn't Chicago, you know. Listen, I brought in these fellas to help us out. These guys are on the ball. They'll take care of the shark. And they can also help us sort out the situation at the aquarium. Listen, hey, when we're done, we won't forget you.
You can always count on me.
Yeah, sure. And of course, it's clear, we'll take the 100,000 reward.
Of course. Of course.
We'll be seeing
you. You sent Ronnie to die because you're scared of your partners?
I only did it for you all. For your well-being.
I pity you.
Where are you going now?
Warn Dag Soerensen. He's only decent to work on this time.
You're not going anywhere! Get up here!
And you're staying locked up in here until this is over!
The Cleveland was an oceanographic ship carrying a very special cargo, right?
Yep, it ran aground on the sandbanks during a storm and sank.
In exactly the same point where we ran into trouble today.
But what's the wreck got to do with the shark?
That ship was carrying a shark born in captivity. Top secret naval experiments. A death machine trained to attack the enemy. Now, if the theory of territoriality is correct, and I have no reason to doubt it, the wreck of the Cleveland is where that thing lives. And the sea around here is its hunting reserve. Here's my plan. We go down to the wreck of the Cleveland, we fill it with dynamite, and we blow it to bits.
Oh, sure. Who says the shark's gonna be blown up with it?
Well, if the territorial theory is correct, our presence in his territory is gonna make him come run.
Gloria!
I've been looking for you everywhere. My father.
What's happened?
Someone's trying to get their hands on the aquarium. My father's in cahoots with them. They're bad people. You're in danger.
Susie, she's all alone at the aquarium.
Look, man, aren't they the ones who were supposed to leave the boss alone to take care of?
That's them, all right. What do? We follow them.
No, first I want to have a look in there.
Gloria and I will stay here. Bob, you stand guard on the boat. Larry, you go with it. Billy, go back to the Institute and get your maps. Tomorrow we're sailing at 6. Gloria? You can stay the night with Susie, okay?
Hey. Shit! This is hot stuff! We get there before they do, we'll be filthy rich. But first, there's something we've gotta do.
Everything looks okay here.
Wrong! Let's fix the engine.
Well, what about them?
We'll leave them here. Come on.
revved up the engine the best I can. Try and start her up, Larry. Try it now.
They've just got poison here to kill an elephant.
Going by the map, this is the spot. Be careful, Matt. That shark's been trained by the Navy. You know how they do.
Don't worry, I was in the Marines.
Goodbye, honey. Gloria will take care of you while I'm away.
Daddy, give that shark a punch in the nose for me.
You bet I will.
I love you.
Be careful.
Whatever happens, remember I love you.
We're here, Larry. Cut the engine.
I want you guys to be careful. If he realizes you're down there, he won't leave you in peace. Lay the charges quickly, light the fuses, and get the hell out of there. God be with you, boys.
For the citizenry of Hampton Bay, I'd like to present this check to Dag Soerensen. Huh?